Last topic in this chapter solutions is abnormal molecular masses. Already in the previous class we have discussed about colligative properties. What are those properties? Relative lowering of vapor pressure, RLVP, elevation in the boiling point of solvent, delta TB, depression in the freezing point of solvent, delta TF, and osmotic pressure, pi. These properties we have discussed. So using these colligative properties, if you find out the molecular mass, I said earlier, the purpose of colligative properties is to determine the molecular weight of unknown substance. So when we calculate the molecular mass of unknown substance using these colligative properties, they are giving accurate values for some solutes, but abnormal values for some other solutes. Why the abnormal values are obtaining? Why for some solutes correct values, for some other solutes abnormal values? For that, let's have a look on this topic. So any colligative property, I said earlier, any colligative property that may be RLVP, delta TB, delta TF or pi, directly proportional to particle concentration. Directly proportional to particle concentration and inversely proportional to gram molecular weight of a solute. Gram molecular weight of solute. If weight of a solute is same, any colligative property is directly proportional to particle concentration, but inversely proportional to gram molecular weight. You know, the observed value and the calculated value, molecular weights. If you take urea, what is molecular weight of urea? For urea, molecular weight is 60. So from the formula NH2CO NH2, so using the formula, when you calculate the molecular mass, its value how much? 60. If you find out this value using any colligative property method, then also you will get 60. So for the substances like urea, glucose, sucrose, the observed value, observed molecular weight value and calculated value are same. So for which substances these are same? For the substances which do not undergo any dissociation and association. For solutes which do not undergo dissociation or association, in the solution, this gram molecular weight observed value, that means gram molecular weight calculated from the experiment and gram molecular weight of solute calculated value means calculated from the formula. I said na earlier, for urea calculated value 60, from the formula we can get the value 60. From the experiment also it is 60. So there no abnormality. So can you say some examples which cannot undergo dissociation and which cannot undergo association? Examples are urea, glucose, sucrose, etc. When they are placed in water, they do not give ions. Like NaCl, they do not give ions. Like acetic acid in benzene, they do not associate. Dissociation means NaCl dissociates to Na plus and Cl minus. In dissociation, particles number increases, whereas in association, particles number decreases. What are associating substances? Acetic acid, benzoic acid in benzene. They undergo dimerization. Okay. So for such substances, So molecular weights are not same for observed and calculated value. But for urea, glucose, sucrose, observed value, calculated value are same. But for solutes which undergo dissociation, you know, gram molecular weight calculated from experiment not equal to gram molecular weight calculated from the formula. Not equal to means which is more, calculated or observed. For that, see, if you take NaCl, for this some examples are NaCl, sodium sulfate, okay, K3FeCN6, okay, so etc. These are some dissociating compounds. NaCl give two particles, Na2SO4 gives three particles, K3FeCN6 gives four particles. So these are some examples for dissociating solutes. For such solutes, see, NaCl we are considering as one particle, but when it is placed in water, it dissociates to two particles. We are considering one, but there are two. That means particle concentration is increasing. So than expected, colligative property increases. If colligative property increases, its gram molecular weight decreases. So observed colligative property, observed value is lesser than calculated value. If you see, for NaCl, what is its gram molecular mass? That means formula weight. Its formula weight is 58.5. For NaCl, its gram formula weight is 58.5. If you find out this value using colligative property method, you will get 58.5 by 2. Half only. Half the value we are getting. What is the reason? See here, the reason is we are considering NaCl as a single particle. But in solution, its number gets doubled. Because of doubling the particle concentration, Cp also gets doubled. As Cp gets doubled, gram molecular mass gets halved. That means it becomes half. So that is the reason. So for such solutes, observed value is less than the calculated value. Similarly, for solutes which undergo association, so these are the examples in water. Okay, similarly these are examples in water. They do not undergo association or dissociation. These in water undergo dissociation. See here examples. Here what is the relation? Gram molecular weight of solute observed, here also not equal to gram molecular weight of, what is that? Calculated value. What is the relation here? Here, observed value is greater than the calculated. See an example. Acetic acid, CH3COOH. Similarly, benzoic acid, C6H5COOH. In benzene, C6H6. They undergo, see the examples for these solutes which undergo association. Acetic acid, CH3COOH, benzoic acid, C6H5COOH, in benzene they undergo association. Why there occurs association? Because of intermolecular hydrogen bonding, there occurs association. See, when acetic acid is placed in benzene, there occurs association like this. This is the structure of acetic acid. Similarly, take one more acetic acid molecule. Here what happens is, it is then carbon oxygen is more polar, that's why delta minus, here delta plus. There occurs hydrogen bonding. Similarly, here also delta minus, delta plus, there occurs hydrogen bonding. So it is simply written as CH3COOH taken twice. So there occurs association. If you take 100 molecules in benzene, 100 molecules of acetic acid, there will be 50 molecules only. If 100% association takes place there will be 50 molecules only. That means here number of particles are decreasing. We are saying that acetic acid 100 molecules, but in the solution there are only 50. So number of particles decreasing. When particle concentration is decreasing, its colligative property also decreases. When colligative property decreases, molecular weight increases. That's why observed value is greater than theoretical value. You know, acetic acid gram molecular mass is, what is the gram molecular weight of acetic acid? 60. It is the calculated value. From the formula, it is 60. Okay. But when you do experiment using any colligative property, when we calculate its value, you will get 120, which is double. So observed value 120, calculated value 60, which is more observed. So in that way, there is abnormality in the molecular mass of substances which undergo association and dissociation in solvents. So to avoid this abnormality, Vadhoff suggested that to introduce a factor into each colligative property. So from that, to avoid this abnormality in the molecular masses, abnormality in the molecular masses, Van't Hoff introduced a factor I, a factor I called Van 't Hoff factor. Van 't Hoff factor. Van 't Hoff factor in the colligative property expression. In the colligative property expression. So I is introduced. So that's why now colligative properties, all we have discussed earlier, those properties to be modified, because those expressions are valid for non-dissociating and non-associating substances. But those expressions fail in the case of dissociating and associating substances. That's why to be modified. So Van 't Hoff modified all those equations by introducing this factor called Van 't Hoff factor. Now see all the properties now. What is first colligative property? RLVP. Okay. RLVP means delta P by P naught is equal to, what is the formula? Mole fraction of solute. Van 't Hoff factor into mole fraction of solute. Actually, we discussed this equation without Van 't Hoff factor. But we are not getting the molecular masses accurate. That's why Van 't Hoff introduced I. Similarly, what is the second colligative property? Elevation in the boiling point. What is that? Delta TB is equal to, what is the formula? KB into molality. This is the expression for elevation in the boiling point. Introduce Van 't Hoff factor. Similarly, delta TF, it means depression in the freezing point, is equal to, what is the formula? KF into molality. There also he introduced Van 't Hoff factor. Fourth one, pi, osmotic pressure pi is equal to CRT. This is the formula. There also Van der Hoff factor is introduced. If you use this formula now, you will get the accurate value. That means observed molecular weight, calculated molecular mass, we get same by using these expressions. So in that way, all the expressions of colligative properties are modified by Van der Hoff factor. Okay, now let's see the topic about Van der Hoff factor. What is this? Van der Hoff factor. It is denoted by I. Its formula is observed colligative property, observed colligative property by observed or experimental, observed or experimental colligative property, CP means colligative property, okay, by calculated or theoretical colligative property. So to determine Van der Hoff factor, this is one formula: observed or experimental colligative property by calculated or theoretical colligative property. That means, see here, how to RLVP observed by RLVP theoretical or calculated. Similarly, delta TB observed by delta TB calculated. Similarly, delta TF observed by delta TF calculated. Pi observed by pi calculated. So in that way, we use this formula to find out Van der Hoff factor. Similarly, in terms of molecular mass, what is that? Calculated or theoretical? Theoretical gram molecular weight. Calculated or theoretical gram molecular weight by observed or theoretical gram molecular weight of solute. We can use this formula also. How can we get theoretical value? From the formula acetic acid, from the formula 60, glucose from the formula 180, okay, urea from the formula 60. So in that way, from the formula we calculate na molecular mass, that is theoretical or calculated. From the experiment also we get na, that is observed. Okay, so without Van der Hoff factor we get na experimental value, that is called observed value. So this ratio gives Van der Hoff factor. See one more formula: number of particles after dissociation or association. Number of particles after dissociation or association in the solution by number of particles before dissociation or association. These are the formulae to find out Van der Hoff factor. Okay, so using this Van der Hoff factor, we find the molecular mass of substance from these expressions. Now, what is Van der Hoff factor value for non-electrolytes and electrolytes? You know, Van der Hoff factor I is equal to 1 for non-electrolytes. Van der Hoff factor I is equal to 1 for non-electrolytes. Non-electrolyte means glucose, urea, fructose, okay, etc. For these non-electrolytes, Van der Hoff factor is 1. So in the formula, in the colligative property modified expression, in place of I, take 1. Similarly, I is equal to N, where N is a number of particles for strong electrolytes. Strong electrolytes are strong electrolytes and 100% dissociation of 100% dissociation of electrolytes. Electrolyte means which dissolves in water and gives ions is said to be electrolyte. NaCl is an electrolyte because it dissolves in water at the same time gives ions. Okay, so for where here N is, what is N? Number of particles. Number of particles obtained after ionization. Obtained after ionization. See some examples. If you take NaCl, its Van der Waals factor I equal to 2. If it is 100% ionized, if it is considered as a strong electrolyte, then I is equal to 2. Why I is equal to 2? Because NaCl gives 2 particles by ionization. Similarly, for Na2SO4, its Van der Waals factor I equal to 3. Similarly, for AlCl3, Van der Waals factor I equal to 4. For K4FeCN6, its Van der Waals factor I is equal to 5. So in that way, for a strong electrolyte or for an electrolyte which undergoes 100% dissociation, Van der Waals factor is considered as N, where N is number of particles obtained. Now, what is Van der Waals factor for dissociation and association? Let us derive degree of dissociation and association using Van der Waals factor. So, first one, Van der Waals factor for dissociation. Van der Waals factor for dissociation. For that, let us take an electrolyte An. It dissociates to Na. Let initial number of particles 1. Initial number of particles 1. Here 0. Before dissociation, number of particles of An 1. Number of particles of A 0. After dissociation, let the number of particles left 1 minus alpha, then number of particles of A formed are N alpha. These are initial, that means when T equal to 0, that means no dissociation of 1, 0. When time at T, at certain time, number of particles of An left 1 minus alpha, number of particles of A formed N alpha, because one particle if undergoes dissociation, it gives Na. One particle gives N particles, then alpha particles gives how many? N alpha particles. Okay, from this, see the Van der Waals factor. Van der Waals factor I is equal to, what is the formula? Total particles after dissociation by total particles before dissociation. Okay. So, total particles after dissociation by particles, total particles before dissociation. See, after dissociation, how many particles in the vessel? 1 minus alpha of particles of A, N, A, 1 minus alpha particles of A, N, N alpha particles of Na, 1 minus alpha particles of An, N alpha particles of A, That means after dissociation total particles 1 minus alpha plus n alpha by before dissociation how many? 1. So 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. This is the expression for dissociating substances. This implies alpha, how to write here? Alpha, degree of dissociation. How to write? For degree of dissociation alpha, here if you take common, then I minus 1 by, here if you take alpha common, that is n minus 1, okay, n minus 1. This is the relation between degree of dissociation alpha and Van 't Hoff factor I. So where alpha is degree of dissociation, degree of dissociation, got it? Similarly, B, Van 't Hoff factor for association. Van 't Hoff factor for association. Let's see some points here. For dissociation, what happens is Van 't Hoff factor I is always greater than 1. For dissociation process, Van 't Hoff factor, why it is more than 1? Because initially 1, now 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. 1 minus alpha plus n alpha is always more than 1. So Van 't Hoff factor 1. Van 't Hoff factor more than 1 means colligative property observed is more than colligative property calculated. That means colligative property gram molecular weight observed is less than gram molecular weight calculated. So when Van 't Hoff factor greater than 1, these are the relations. Okay, got it. Similarly, B for Van 't Hoff factor, Van 't Hoff factor for association, Van 't Hoff factor for association. You know, the reverse of dissociation is called what? Association. That's why take the reverse reaction. N moles of A gets associated to An. If you take n particles na, that become one particle. Let the initial particles, that means when there is no association, particles 1, here 0. After some time t, the number of particles of A left, 1 minus alpha, alpha gets associated. So if alpha gets associated, how much will be left? 1 minus alpha. That side, how many particles will be formed? So for that, compare the coefficients. If n goes, it becomes 1. If n goes, becomes 1. Alpha goes, alpha by n. So number of particles formed are alpha by n. So now, what is the expression for Van 't Hoff factor here? Van 't Hoff factor I is equal to, similar formula, total particles after association by Van 't Hoff factor, now I for association. How to write? Number of particles after association by number of particles before association. So already we have after association how many particles? 1 minus alpha from reactant side plus alpha by n from product side, whole divided by 1. Number of particles before association is 1. Number of particles after association is this total. That's why here, so finally we got that I Van 't Hoff factor is equal to 1 minus alpha plus alpha by n. This is the expression we use for association, where alpha is, here alpha is degree of association. Alpha is degree of association. Then how to find out the formula for alpha? From this C, take here I minus 1, there I minus 1 equals to alpha by n minus alpha. Take alpha common. Then I minus 1 is equal to here, what is that? 1 minus n by n. Okay. Now alpha equals to I minus 1 into n by 1 minus n. I minus 1 into n by, this is the expression for degree of association. Wait. Degree of association. Next, here also, see, when for association process, Van der Haaf factor I is less than 1. Colligative property observed is less than colligative property calculated. Similarly, gram molecular weight of substance observed is greater than gram molecular weight of substance calculated. Okay, so this is a Van der Haaf factor calculation for association.